my mouth and the meditation of our heart through is pleasing in your sight, O Lord, our strength and our redeemer. Amen. Amen. So, I don't know if you've ever seen them, but there's a sort of a spear thing called a boar spear. And they were used by people who hunt boars before they used things like guns and stuff. And they've got a fairly broad blade, and they're quite long, and they've got a crossbar on it. And they seem like a really big weapon if your picture of a boar is basically the same as the picture of a pig, which in my mind comes from Babe, Pig in the City, and it's a small, cute little pink thing. However, a boar is not a small, cute little pink thing. It is big, and it's muscly, and it's hard, and it's got tusks. And basically, there's a reason you want a really, really long stick between you and said boar, if you're hunting them. Which sort of starts to explain why, although often when we picture the Roman legions, and we picture them sort of walking with a standard, we picture the eagle. But that's like Caesar's legion. Most of them went with the boar as their symbol. So Jesus comes across to the region of the Gadarenes, and he comes across two demon-possessed men who are violent. They are men of conflict. Sort of like the Roman legions, maybe. I like Jesus when he's political. And so they come and they approach Jesus. And they're yelling at him, and what do you want with us, Son of God? And have you come to torture us before the appointed time? And then they say, if you're going to drive us out, send us into the herd of pigs. Pigs are the Romans. The pigs and the boars are the Roman legion's symbol. These are men of violence in an area that has had Roman conflict. And then the herd of pigs rush down into the water. And if you're a good Jewish person, you've got pigs, which are unclean, and you've got water, which is always going to evoke a couple of symbols, particularly for many of them, God's Spirit hovers over the water, then it's from the chaos that new life can emerge. But it's also that they escaped from Egypt through water. And so we get all these symbols of water, and the water is chaotic, but it's also life-giving. So there's a profoundly political set of narratives tied up here. There's the kind of the association of the Romans with the uncleanness of the pig, and also with the violence and with the darkness, the demonic, and the fact that they are destroyed. But they recognize the authority that Jesus carries in this circumstance, which I think leads us with a couple of things. One of the questions I would have is, these people who are looking after the pigs, they rush off to the town, they tell everyone what's happened, and they all come back and they say to Jesus, thank you so much for freeing us from these violent men. No, they don't. What they say is, please leave. Please leave. We have found ways to accommodate the violence, but we're not up to taking the economic hit of losing our pigs. It's not what they say, but it's what they're saying, isn't it? We would rather have the violence and the inhumanity that goes with that than take the economic hit of losing another, I don't know what is the herd of pigs. It's an important thing for us to recognize. So what does that mean for us? What does that mean for us as a society and as individuals? The first thing is that we need to recognize that where people have been violent, the Romans have been in this part of the world, we are likely to see more violence and pain and suffering. These things have a generational impact. People who grow up with violence tend to become violent people. People who grow up with generosity and love are more likely to grow up to be people who are generous and loving. We need to be aware of our politics. Politics is not always about Labour and Coalition and Liberal and Greens and Democrats and all the rest of it. It's about understanding how human beings operate and trying to operate within that context. So we're all, in that sense, politicians because we're part of society. We might not be politicians because we're part of a party, but we're politicians because we operate within a society that interacts with people. We need to be aware of the politics of power here. Jesus has the power over this violence. But we also need to be warned deeply about our societies and our society is made up of us. Our society's ability to sanction, condone violence for the economic benefit. Because that is demonic. To say it's okay for other people to suffer for my hip pocket. We have a choice where we want to be. We need to exercise that choice. In the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, Amen.